Hello everyone and welcome to another video. In this video, I would like to discuss the concept of confounding bias, which is widely discussed in epidemiology, but through a different perspective using parametric equations. For those of you who don't know, parametric equations are tools frequently used in calculus, and my idea here is to try to mix epidemiology and calculus to see what sort of additional insights we can gain on our understanding of confounding. To start off our discussion, let's first consider this directed acyclic graph, or DAG for short, shown here on the screen. So here we have our exposure or treatment variable that we're going to call X, our outcome or response variable Y, and our confounder variable, which is just a common cause of X and Y, we are going to call this variable C. And for those of you who know DAGs, we can clearly see that the association between X and Y without adjustment for C is confounded, and therefore this simple association does not estimate the causal effect of X on Y. For those of you who don't know about DAGs, I have plenty of content about DAGs in my causal inference classes. I'll leave links for these classes in the description of this video. At the moment, I only have those classes in Brazilian Portuguese, but my plan is in the near future to translate those classes to English as well. So make sure to check the link in the description to see if the translated classes are already available or not. For the purposes of this video, we can simplify the DAG into a path diagram. A DAG is a non-parametric representation of causal relationships between variables, whereas in a path diagram, we assume that all associations are linear without effect modification in the additive scale. So in our example, we have a path diagram shown on the screen, which is just the previous DAG, but parametrized as the following data generating model. We have our confounder C, which we are assuming to be normally distributed with mean of 0 and variance of 1, so just the standard normal distribution. X is 0.6 times C. In other words, a 1 unit increase in C causes an increase of 0.6 units in X. And similarly, Y is also caused by C, with a unit increase in C causing a 0.3 unit increase in Y. And we're also assuming that X and Y are not causally related. In other words, the causal effect of X on Y is 0. So from this DAG, we can see that there is no causal effect, or the causal effect is just 0. But as we discussed already, there is confounding between X and Y. So the association between X and Y without adjustment for C is certainly not 0, it's certainly different than 0 due to bias. So now imagine that we have a data set generated according to the data generating model that I just described. And we have measured for a given set of individuals the variable X, the variable Y, but not the variable C. In this situation, we can only calculate the unadjusted association between X and Y. And of course, in this case, we know that this unadjusted association does not correspond to the causal effect of X and Y due to unmeasured confounding. So then, if we adjust a simple linear regression model to this data, the result will be an intercept of 0 and a slope of 0.5. We can clearly see this in this scatter plot, where we have the exposure in the x-axis, the outcome in the y-axis. Each circle indicates a data point, and the solid line indicates the sort of diagonal line, that is, the line that passes through the origin with a slope of 1, and we can clearly see that our points align in a line that has a slope that's about half of the diagonal line, and the x-axis indicated by the horizontal dashed line, so sort of corroborating this numerical result that we have here. Why are X and Y associated, given that there is no causal relationship between them? This is due to confounding, as we already know and discussed. And indeed, since we know the data generating model in this situation, of course, X and Y would be associated. But if you go a little bit further, we can ask the following question. Why is the slope equal to 0.5 exactly? instead of any other number such as 0.1 or 2.3. We would expect positive confounding because C has a positive causal effect on X and a positive causal effect on Y. But how do we arrive at this slope of 0.5 precisely? This is the question that we're going to try to answer using parametric equations. So to start our argument, let's just rewrite the equations for X and Y. So X equals 0.6 times C and Y equals 0.3 times C. These are just the equations that we already discussed when we were presenting the data generating model of our example. So here we can clearly see that X and Y are not functions of one another, but instead are both functions of a third common variable C. And in this situation, we can say that X and Y are a pair of parametric equations because they are both based on a common parameter, in this case, the variable C, which is our confounder. And the beauty of this is that we can use this notion that X and Y are a pair of parametric equations to find an equation that relates X and Y. It's important to understand that this relation is not causal. Because we know the data generating model, we know that there is no causal relationship between X and Y, and that any relation between these two variables that we're going to define using parametric equations happens due to bias. That is, we're going to use this idea of parametric equations to find an equation that describes the sort of biased relationship between X and Y, or the associational relationship between X and Y. And indeed, this is just another instance of the more general and widespread idea that association is not always equal to causation. So to understand how we can arrive at the associational relationship between X and Y, let's do some simple algebraic manipulations of the two equations that define X and Y as a function of the common parameter C. Starting with the equation for X, if we divide both sides by 0.6, we can isolate C so that C equals X divided by 0.6. If we do the same with regard to the equation for Y, we arrive at C equals Y divided by 0.3. A trivial statement is that C equals C, right? I mean, 2 is equal to 2, 10 is equal to 10, minus 17 equals minus 17, pi is equal to pi, C is equal to C. An implication of this is that Y divided by 0.3 equals X divided by 0.6, because both of these are equal to C as we derived above. After we have this equality, we can do some simple algebraic manipulations to isolate Y on one side of the equation, and we arrived at the relationship Y equals to 0.5 times X. So from this derivation, we can see that based on the pair of parametric equations, we can arrive at a third equation that relates X and Y directly without mentioning the parameter C. Therefore, we can conclude that there is a mathematical relationship between X and Y. More specifically, in our example, Y is a linear function of X with intercept 0 and slope of 0.5. And this relationship is, of course, non-causal, as we discussed already. Notice that the result from our parametric equation derivation was the same result that we obtained through linear regression. Is this a coincidence? Of course not. The thing is that from the parametric equations for X and Y, we can derive the equation that describes the association between X and Y, because both X and Y have a common parameter C, and by the equality C equals C, we can then arrive at an equation that relates X and Y directly. Therefore, X and Y have a common parameter C, which is our confounder, and this is precisely the reason why we can arrive at an equation that relates both variables. And really, the overall conclusion of this video is that associations between variables due to confounding can be interpreted in light of parametric equations. We saw that we can use the notion that X and Y can be understood as a pair of parametric equations to arrive at an equation that describes the associational relationship between X and Y directly, thus helping us to understand why X and Y are related in the way that they are. Before ending this video, guys, I just wanted to point out that the example was very simplified. We assumed that C is the single cause of both X and Y. We could easily make this more complicated and likely more realistic by adding additional causes for both variables, adding nonlinear relationships, adding effect modification, and so on. But really, the point of this video was to illustrate more conceptually that we can understand how confounding comes about through the lens of this idea of parametric equations. So that's it for this video. I hope you guys found it helpful and interesting. Let me know if there is any specific thing you would like me to cover, or if there are any questions about this topic, I'll be happy to answer those as well. That's it, guys. Take care. I'll see you in the next video.